Automation is coming to the oil field. For some, this is a cause for excitement as they see opportunities for efficiency gains and lower emissions. For others, this is cause for anxiety as they feel intimidated by the seeming complexities of electric power. I'm Jordan with Kimray, where we help energy producers solve their biggest control challenges. Oilfield automation is an exciting new challenge that has big upsides for oil and gas producers. As an applications technician specializing in Kimray's electric products, I help producers tackle questions about electric products and processes regularly. In this video, I want to help you become familiar with six key terms in oil and gas automation. The first term we want to go over is PLC. A PLC, which stands for Programmable Logic Controller, is a computer that's been programmed to control a process. A PLC receives information about process conditions and then sends information to a control device on a production site in order to control them. Let's take a brief look at one example of how a PLC could work. An electric temperature controller is digitally reading a temperature in a heater treater. You have specified a set point in your PLC and set a protocol so that it will react when the temperature reading gets above or below that set point. To send and receive this data, a PLC uses a communication system called SCADA. If the temperature gets above the set point, the PLC will send a signal to a burner valve to reduce the amount of supply gas going to your burner, which will lower the temperature. The next term we'd like to cover is RTU. An RTU, which stands for Remote Terminal Unit, is a basic digital readout box on a well site that receives process conditions from controllers and pilots. These readouts may be temperature or pressure readings, among others. Some have touch screens, while others have simple digital readouts. RTUs are controlled by and send process information to a SCADA system, which receives the information and supervises the RTUs. The functions of both RTUs and PLCs overlap, and their capabilities vary, making generalizations difficult. This is a quick look at some of the key differences between the two units. Click the link below to visit our blog page about this topic and spend a little more time going through these capabilities. The third term we'd like to go over is I2P positioner. An I2P positioner is a device that receives an electrical current signal, abbreviated I, and converts it to a corresponding pneumatic signal, abbreviated P. To do this, it also has a supply gas input that provides the pneumatic pressure. For instance, our YAK2 receives a 4 to 20 milliamp signal and converts it to a corresponding 6 to 30 PSI pneumatic signal, which it sends to the pneumatic actuator of a control valve. Next, let's talk about transducers. A transducer receives a pneumatic signal and converts it to a corresponding electrical signal. One example of an I2P and transducer working together is on our electric valve controller. On this package, the transducer measures process pressure and gives a raw 4 to 20 milliamp signal to the pilot. The electric pilot then takes that signal and converts it to a proportional 4 to 20 milliamp signal and sends that to the I2P positioner. The I2P positioner converts that electric input signal to a corresponding 6 to 30 PSI output signal and sends that level of supply gas to the high pressure control valve. Some people wonder why they need the pilot in this instance. Well, without the pilot, there is no decision maker. The pilot takes that raw transducer signal and converts it to an accurate corresponding pressure. The fifth term that we'd like to cover is solar panel. A solar panel uses UV light to produce DC electricity, which most electric control equipment can run on. Now you may wonder what happens at night or on a cloudy day. Well, the power captured from the sun is stored in a battery or a bank of batteries. Solar panels can be used in an array of oil and gas applications and are common in more remote areas. Solar panels allow you to reap the benefits of electric power without the cost of running electric wiring to your site. The last terms we'll be covering in this video are AC and DC. Now, when you think of electricity, you're probably thinking of plugging a device into a wall. That is AC. On a well site, AC power can come from wires run to a nearby power pole. One common product that uses AC is an electric submersible pump, which is used for artificial lift. DC, which stands for direct current, is what's stored in batteries. On a well site, DC is most often generated by solar panels, though it may also derive from a converter, which converts AC to DC electricity. For further questions or to speak with an expert on how to use automation in your next project, contact your local Chemray store or authorized distributor, and I or another technician will be happy to help.